Hello, namaste to all. From the previous sessions, you may identify few tips which are very helpful while you are dealing with the online tools. They are very much helpful to prepare the e-content. So in this session, few more tips you may learn. Let us start. So generally in the Windows, one application is there like Magnifier. Please observe here, Magnifier app that you are observing. If I am clicking it, the magnifier, that window will come here. Even in the toolbar also you can observe. You can reduce the size, you can increase, means zoom in, zoom out, you can perform. Different view options are there like full screen mode, lens mode, docked mode. Full screen mode means the complete window, whatever you are observing on that screen, that will be zoomed out or zoomed in. Whenever you are selecting lens, only particular portion you may magnify. Whenever you are selecting the dark, only in this area the portion will be zoomed like a strip. If you are selecting full screen, please observe. So whenever you are moving the cursor, the complete screen, that may be zoomed in or zoomed out. If I am selecting lens option, only particular area that will be zoomed in or zoomed out. So what is the use of this particular magnifier app? Whenever you are recording your lecture, if you want to highlight one thing from your screen, if the audience, if they are unable to watch the content clearly, then you can use magnifier app to show the content clearly. For example, actually here I want to tell one website name like otter.ai. Simply I typed in the browser. Suppose whenever I am using this particular magnifier app, if I am choosing the lens option, please observe the website name, that is very clear now. So simply by using this particular app, you can zoom in very easily. Here I want to explain something. Suppose the font is very less, then by using this particular lens, I can show the spelling or content very comfortably to my audience. That is the particular usage of this particular magnifier app. 300. 400. Full screen option or lens option or docked option. If I don't want, then I need to click the cross mark. So that is the use of the magnifier app. So that is the tip one for this session. Tip two, I have shown one website name here, otter.ai, otter.ai. What is the use of this particular website? In the previous session, I told some tricks to convert voice into the text. This particular website is also intended for the same purpose. First of all, you need to log in with your Gmail account. They will give nearly 600 minutes as the free bonus time for the first time whenever you are using this particular website. Later you need to purchase according to your requirement. So what is the usage of this particular website? Suppose from the Zoom meeting or from any meeting in your college or from some place, you have recording. Speaker 1, speaker 2, speaker 3, they will speak something. So whenever you are playing that particular audio or video, and whenever you are clicking the particular recording tab here, so automatically it will convert the total speech into the text. So here, speaker 1, speaker 2, whenever their voice is changing, it will show the text with the heading speaker 1 and speaker 2 automatically. It will recognize. And you can share the complete conversation with your friend also. And you will receive the conversation also from them. So let us see a small demo now. So please observe here, record option is there, microphone symbol is there. Hello. Hello. Welcome to all. How are my sessions? Hope you are enjoying the content. This is one tip corresponding to voice to text conversion. Voice to text conversion. So just by clicking that record button, you can say something. Automatically the particular website, that particular application, that will convert your voice into the text. That will be preserved in your account. Whenever you are clicking the particular file, that will show the converted text as well as the particular audio clip also. So whenever we are moving in a car, or whenever we are acting like a member in a meeting, simply by using this particular app, we can record the complete conversation, and at the same time it will convert the complete conversation into the text form also. So very easily we can prepare the minutes of meeting. If there is emergency need to convert into the text, then we can use this particular app. Now please observe, just I pronounce it like hello, hello, welcome to all, how are my sessions, hope you are enjoying the content. So everything that is appearing here, here play button is there. So please observe, you can listen the audio once again, and at the same time you can observe what are the words pronounced by that particular speaker at that moment. We can edit also, even we can share with your friends also. So that is one usage of this particular website. Some customized plans are also available. So based on our requirement, we will use the particular features. So here some sample Word document is available with me. Simply I saved as the PDF. So now PDF is available with me. If you are having Adobe Pro version or Adobe Extended version in your computer, you can use some of the features like by clicking the document. Please observe, here some tabs are there: file, edit, view, document, comments, tools, etc. So from the document tab, you can insert the pages, additional pages from another PDF to this PDF. You can extract, means you can split all the pages, or you can extract one or two pages from this PDF to another file. You can replace some of the pages with new pages. Even you can delete the pages also. OCR text recognition option is also there. Means whenever image is available in the PDF, then automatically it will show the complete text. When normal text is available, no problem. Just by using your mouse, you will select the content and you will copy to some other file. And you can add sticky notes also. You can add some comment also easily. In the tools, please observe, in the tools, select and zoom sub option is there. Here, snapshot tool is available. Snapshot tool is available. What is the use of the snapshot tool? So I want to select this particular paragraph. And simply I may copy. Please observe, this is in the image format. This is in the image format. So whenever from a PDF, if you want to copy the content or any diagram in the image manner, then use the snapshot tool. The tools, select and zoom option will be there, and please observe, snap shot tool option is there. By using this particular option, you can select any information from the PDF, then simply you can copy the same information into some other document or into some other place. Go to that PDF. Okay, advanced. please observe here, advanced editing option is there. In the advanced editing, touch up text tool option is there. Touch up text tool. If I am clicking here, then it will load some system fonts initially. So I want to change or modify few of the words. Please observe. So initially some words are there. I am modifying those words in the PDF. It's not a Word document. In the Word document, easily you can modify the content, but generally in the PDF it is not possible. But whenever you are having the Adobe Pro version or Adobe Extended version in your computer, simply you can modify the content also. That option is available in the Adobe Pro version. And finally, you are supposed to save to keep the changes. Similarly, in the document, if I want to delete the first page, 1-to-1 I selected. So please observe, initially 4 pages are there, now only 3 pages are there. So I saved the document. Suppose you are not having Adobe Pro version in your computer, then generally you will use some third party websites to include all these features sometimes. So let us see now. So whenever I am typing like PDF to Word in the Google search, there are so many websites. Smallpdf.com is there. So now it will convert PDF to Word. So I will choose the PDF. It is uploading. So convert to Word I am selecting. Now it is converting the given document from PDF to Word. Download option is there. Please observe, sample Word document converted. That is the file name. So now you can modify the content, or you can include the changes, and finally you can convert once again into the PDF, either by using particular add-on. Even if the add-on is not available, choose any particular website like Word2PDF. Word2PDF. You can upload the Word document, MS Word document, and you can download PDF. That option is available. Now I want to edit the PDF. So PDF editor online, that was typed by me in the Google search. Please observe, one site is there, SCJDA, sejda.com, you can pronounce like that. Where is the magnifier? Please observe, SEJDA.com. Is it okay for everyone? So upload PDF file, that option is there. So please observe, on my desktop sample Word document with that name one PDF is available. Simply I uploaded this particular PDF in the website named as the sejda.com. Here please observe, some options are there. Text, you can add new text here. I am clicking here. I am typing like hello, this is ICT session by Mr. VVS Murthy. I can change the font, I can change the size, even I can modify the color also, bold, italic. If I don't want to include, I can delete also. Please observe, what I did actually, in the given PDF document some words are there initially. I can remove or I can edit those also by using this particular website. In the empty place I can add new text. Or even I can modify the existing text also by using this particular website. Even you can include some new images. In the PDF, some gap is available. You want to include one image in that gap and you want to save the document as a new one, then simply by using this particular option you can insert the image into the existing PDF. You can sign also, you can add your signature. White out option is there, white out. So I am selecting this particular area. Please observe, then automatically in that area the complete content that I can remove. Is it okay? So whenever you are downloading the information generally from some other website, you may identify the faculty name and their college name like header or footer in that particular PDF. Generally, we are supposed to remove the particular one or two lines completely and then it will be useful for some other person. Then whenever you are uploading the particular document in this website by using whiteout option, simply you can erase the complete information in that selected area. You can highlight or underline or strike through. Annotations you can identify. highlight option is there. You can highlight the text like this and you can save as it is. You can add some ellipse or rectangle shapes also. If you want to highlight this particular paragraph, then you can add the required shape. Apply. So whenever you are finishing all of your jobs, then apply changes you are supposed to click, and finally you can download. Please observe, the input is PDF, the output is also PDF. So from the input PDF to output PDF, try to identify the changes. This text is not available in the previous PDF. By using the text option, I added. Here one paragraph is there initially. Simply I removed it. I highlighted few of the lines. To highlight this particular portion, I added a rectangular shape. So please observe here. There is no watermark. There is no watermark. Like some websites, they will give their website name like sctja.com, or this PDF is prepared by that particular website, or their logo they will insert generally. But here there is no such problem. Whenever you are having Adobe Pro tool in your computer, you can do magic. If Adobe Pro tool is not available in your computer, then also no problem. The Google, there are so many websites. By using those websites, you can do all the required modifications as per our requirement. We can add the text, we can remove, you can add the links, you can add the forms, you can add images, you can add your signature, you can remove the unnecessary part, you can highlight the content, you can add the shape. There are some other options are also there. You can find few of the words and you can replace. Suppose I want to replace each and every word which is looking like some when with some new word, then simply I can. Even undo option is also available. Suppose at any moment if you want to reverse back of your operation, then simply you can select the undo. So all these options are available. Even at the same time you can zoomed in or zoomed out also. So all these possible tools you can enjoy by using the particular website sejda.com. So in this way, from Word to PDF you can convert, or PDF to Word you can convert. You can do modifications as per your wish. So this is the end for this session. So in this session, one website that was introduced, by using that website you can simply narrate something that will convert into text. You can share as a online file to your friend also. The website name is otter.ai, otter.ai, otter.ai. Next, how to convert Word into the PDF, or PDF into the Word. Even what are the online tools to do the same conversion process. If Adobe extended version is available, if Adobe extended version is available in your computer, You can add the pages, you can delete the pages, you can replace the pages, you can modify the content, you can add your signature, you can take the snapshot of the information. Suppose Adobe Extended version is not available in your PC, then by using some other websites, how to do those modifications? Then simply you can modify the PDF document also as per your wish. So this feature is exactly useful whenever you are preparing the e-notes. Generally we will download the e-notes from several sources. Some total 14 pages are there in the PDF. The content is exactly matched with your requirement. But in every page, as header, the some other college name and faculty name that is available. Then by using the washout tool, simply you may remove. Suppose if you want to add one or two new points in that PDF, then also you can add directly. Generally we will do like, first of all we will convert PDF into Word, then we will do all the modifications, and again we will save that Word document into the PDF once again. But by using suitable online tool, we can save the time. Directly in the existing PDF document, we can do modifications and we can save as the new PDF file. Those things they covered in this particular session. In the next session, some more tips may be covered. Thank you. This is the end for this session. Namaste.